My name is Phil Finnemore. I'm with the Australian Building Codes Board, and today I'm going to talk about one part in the framing section of Volume 2, which is relating to H1D6 structural steel members. On the right-hand side, you'll see a deemed to satisfy solution that uses the Nash Residential Suite of Standards, AS4100 or ASNZ4600. If you don't choose that deemed to satisfy solution, you can use the ABCB housing provisions for NCC 2022, specifically part 6.3. So looking at H1D6, starting at subclause 5, this is the link between volume 2 and the housing provisions that are part 6.3 relative to structural steel members. If you choose this path, 6.3 will set out details, and through the acceptable construction practice review, we'll talk about some of the technical changes, but highlighting the connection between volume 2 and the housing provisions rests in H1D6 subclause 5. Before we move on to that, subclause 6, there's a note, it's a new clause in subclause F, and it says the geometric limits set out in AS 4055 clause 1.2 need to be observed. If you're going to use the housing provisions, the design of the building that you're using will have to be within the limits set out in this particular standard. And in summary, clause 1.2 of 4055, that's the wind load for houses, is setting out geometric limits relating to the height of eaves, the maximum height, the width of the building, including verandas and excluding eaves, and also the maximum roof pitch. So if you're within those limits, you can still continue to use the housing provisions for 2022. One of the things the acceptable construction practice review required or desired to have clarified was reference to the first dimension of steel. It currently exists in 2019, but it's a bit vague in its application. So what we've done is set out some examples in here to say that the first dimension of steel to be installed vertically refers to the larger of the two dimensions of a particular steel member. In this case, a 150 by 90 by 8 unequal angle. The larger dimension there of 150 is the first dimension of steel that needs to be installed vertically. So we provided that clarification to say the installation of the first dimension of steel vertically will always refer to the larger of the dimensions of a particular steel element. There's an example of, on the left, the correct way of doing it, the 150 is the vertical dimension because it's greater than 90. It is not acceptable to use that particular dimension horizontally. It will not comply with the first dimension of steel being installed vertically. Structural steel members, a comparison between 2019 volume 2 and part 6.3 in the housing provisions as set out there. What we've done is more clearly articulated separate parts for different structural steel members. 6.3.2 structural steel members overall, and then we go into bearers, strutting beams, lintels, columns, all the way through to corrosion protection, which is an existing set of tables in 2019. Part 6.3.7, right through to 6.3.9, we've added some new requirements and details about fixing and bearing provisions and also allowances and tolerable limits for penetrations. We'll also talk about corrosion protections and in particular how we've explained the use of 2019 provisions for a period of 12 months. Part 6.3 in the housing provisions. There's one important thing to note, and that is there in 6.3.2 subclause 2, there is a requirement for structural steel members to have a minimum nominal yield strength of 250 MPa. Structural standards require a minimum yield strength of steel, and in particular in Australia, we want to make sure the best quality steel is being used, so we've spelt out clearly in the housing provisions a minimum yield strength of 250 MPa for any of the structural steel members set out in 6.3.2, 1, A, B and C. Having a look at some tables, and this has just been put in as an example, the tables have changed a little bit from 2019 to 2022. The information is largely the same, but the format will be slightly different. The table notes, in this case, we've got bearer supporting tiled floors. The table notes are more aligned with structural design, so they complement the information and the data in the tables, and they've been set out in a way that supports our digital format. Some details about cutting and truncations in structural steel members. There are clauses that are relevant to these particular details. We put these in there to graphically illustrate what we're talking about. There's a need to set out dimensions, maximums and minimums in terms of cutting. If you're looking at the diagram on the left, to maintain structural reliability, we've got maximum truncation sizes and depths for particular beams, in this case a strutting beam. We've also got a detail on the right there that sets out timber connections to steel beams for things such as roofs and floors to be supported, including the size of bolts and their maximum centres for connection. We've also included details, and these are not the only details. We do have more, this is just an example, but the connection of steel beams to columns and the need for particular thicknesses of plates, dimensions of plates, connections, bolt sizes and bolt dimensions. We've got base plate connections to steel columns. There are more details in the code. This is just an example to use. We've also got details in explanatory information about the bearing capacities for different types of structural steel members onto columns. And we've also set out some allowable zones and prohibited zones for the penetration through structural steel members for various services, be they plumbing, air conditioning, or whatever the case may be. Corrosion protection. The important thing to note is that for the tables in NCC 2022, we've set out a set of different and new solutions for corrosion protection. They are quite different to the current provisions in the tables for corrosion protection in 2019. But if you have a look at the bottom of this table, we've provided a note there to say for a period of 12 months from the adoption of NCC 2022, you can still use the provisions that exist in 2019. So in summary, from adoption date, you have 12 months that you can still use the 2019 corrosion protection table requirements.